El materialismo moderno priva a la gente de la necesidad de sentirse responsable. Pero si uno se toma la mecánica cuántica en serio, no puede rehuir la responsabilidad y obtiene respuestas que no son claras ni reconfortantes. La mecánica cuántica te dice, sí, el mundo es algo muy grande, muy misterioso. El mecanicismo no es la respuesta, pero no pienso decirte cuál es la respuesta, porque ya tienes edad para decidir por tu cuenta.
¿Cómo se puede seguir viendo el mundo como algo real si el yo que establece que es real es intangible?
Obviously, if we're experiencing more change now in a year than we previously experienced in 1,000 years, we can propagate that trend into the future and see that a day will come when we will experience more change in an hour than we have experienced in the past 20, 30,000 years. A situation like that is unimaginable, so we call it a singularity, a place where the normal rules of modeling break down.
La naturaleza del universo. Realmente solo hay un instante, y es ahora, y es la eternidad. Es un instante en que Dios hace una pregunta, y esa pregunta es, ¿quieres ser uno con la eternidad? Y todos estamos diciendo, no, gracias a un no. Así que tiempo es realmente solo constantemente decir no a la invitación de Dios. Eso es el tiempo. Hay solo una historia. Y esa es la historia de cambiar el no al sí.
Series de la naturaleza, como las semillas en el girasol.
Uno, las matemáticas son el lenguaje de la naturaleza. Dos, todo lo que nos rodea se puede representar y entender mediante números. Tres, si se hace un gráfico con los números de un sistema, se forman modelos. Estos modelos están por todas partes en la naturaleza. Si estamos constituidos por espirales y vivimos en una espiral gigante, todo lo que podemos tocar está formado por espirales.
Se desconoce la ciencia de cómo el pensamiento afecta en realidad a las moléculas.
Right here, right now.
En lo que
observador destruyó la función de onda con solo mirar. Dos electrones creados a la vez están entrelazados. Ambos siguen conectados. El espacio es solo el concepto gracias al cual tenemos la impresión de que hay objetos separados. ¿Nos hemos adentrado lo suficiente en la madriguera?
If it's true that we're all from the center of the star, every atom and each of us from the center of the star, then we're all the same thing. And therefore, it's only me out there. There's nothing to be afraid of because it's all us. The trouble is we have been separated by being born and given a name and an identity and being individuated. We've been separated from the oneness.
Cuando empiezas a darte cuenta de cuál es tu verdadera naturaleza, ya no hay pregunta ni respuesta. Hay una comprensión repentina. Entonces, regresas de la madriguera y empiezas a vivir en un mundo de ilusión, un mundo fantástico y mágico, habiendo entendido que no morirás, que no has nacido.
Instead of looking for a fundamental particle, we should start looking for a fundamental principle of division. We should start looking for a fundamental pattern of creation, because if we understand the pattern, we understand the principle behind the identity. Now we have the key to creation. The key to universal forces. I found eventually that the key was geometry. In a boundary is the possibility of infinite division, and thus infinities and finite structures are complementary. If our universe is expanding, then there must be something contracting, there must be some compression happening in order to get expansion. There must be a feedback between the expansion and the contraction. And the fact that we could start to see the information feedback loop between the radiated side and the contracted side starts to open a whole new field of physics. So basically, Einstein said, gravity is the result of space-time curving like the surface of a trampoline. What we say in this paper, yes, and when space-time curves, it doesn't just curve, but it curls, just like water going down the drain, and that generates spin. And that's the source of the spin of all things. Now, when you look in nature, you can see these dynamics. Taking these principles and applying them to yourself, you could start to visualize, you could start to imagine, you could start to experience that maybe within the confine of the finite structure that you're in is the potential of infinite division, the potential of infinite amount of information. You're transferring that information through your boundary to the infinite of the universe within yourself. Everything we see in the universe is just division of that energy density of the vacuum in various scales. The biological resolution is the link between the large and the small. You are the event horizon. Instead of seeing yourself as an insignificant little dot that means nothing to the universe, you start to see yourself as the center of creation. Everyone else is the center of their universe as well. And thus, we are all equal and we're all one.